This video is made possible together with Rocket Rooster, tools for the digital creator.
Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. If you're interested in learning DaVinci Resolve, filmmaking tips and tricks, reviews, and film-related content, please consider subscribing. So this video is made for the ones who do not use the studio version of DaVinci Resolve 16, but the free version. So if you want to make the effects of old film, we have the old film damage in the studio version, but that doesn't work in the free version. So here I have a video about an alternative how to make that effect. And as you of course saw from the bumper, this video is brought to you together with Rocket Rooster. There will be links down in the description below if you're interested in any of the things from Rocket Rooster, also the things used in this video. And you do not have to use the things from Rocket Rooster if you don't want to. You can find your assets somewhere else, but the pack is $5, so why waste time searching for some free stuff when what they have is so great? Anyway, let's get right to this video.
Okay, so this is just the clip we're going to be working with here. So, for instance, if you had the studio version, you could go into the effects and into the open effects, and then we'll just type in film. And then we're just going to take the film damage and we're just going to drag that on our clip, and then it will do this kind of an effect here. And then, of course, you could go in and change stuff as you wanted. But as you also see, this is kind of heavy on the GPU as well. So so again, this video is for people who do not have the studio version and want to make this old film look. So let's get right into that. I'll just close down the inspector. And then I'll just go to the media pool and I'll go to my master here. And then I'm going to open the pack from Rocket Rooster. This is what I'm using for this video. So first off, let's get some scratches here. Let's see what we have. Okay, let's take, this was not scratches, this was just dust overlay, and then we're going to take, let's take this one. I like that one more, I think. And we're going to add that as well into our timeline. So now we have some scratches and some dust, and to make these visible, of course, we are going to go and change the composite mode to screen. Like so, and we have done that for both clips, so this is what we have here. I'm going to make this a little bit larger, and then I'm going to have a look at this. And then I'm going to take down the opacity of the clip, so they are not so noticeable. I'm going to do the same for the dust. And then there are different overlays here. So we're going to take this 3:3 aspect ratio here. We're going to put that on. And then I'm just going to highlight our clip. I'm going to push Alt. And then I'm drag to do a copy. And I'll do a copy more. And then I'm just going to make this fit the clip like so. And that's the basic of the overlays, of course. So this is what we have now. So let's go into the color tab here and just do some pretty basic stuff. I'm going to take out some saturation. And I'm also going to bump down the contrast a bit. I'm going to push the colors in the gamma towards warm. And I'm doing the same in the lift. And I'll do more or less the same in the gain. And then I'm going to go down here and I'm going to take out some color boost. And then I'm going to change the temperature. And I'm going to mess around with the tint just a little bit. So now we have something like this, which is pretty good, I think. And then, of course, we could make it a little more blurry, the image, if we wanted it to be not as sharp. So that's basically how you would do that. Of course, now you are thinking, maybe you want to to add something, because I want to add a little more, because it was a little too clean for my sake here. So I'm going to add another dust layer. So let's see which one we have. Let's take this one. It's really dusty. And then I'm just going to do the same thing in the composite mode, make that into a screen. And then I'm just going to copy paste it after I take the opacity down a little down. I'm just going to, again, alt drag, copy paste, alt drag, copy paste, and then going to make it fit into my timeline. So now this is the shot I have done, and I'm pretty happy with that. So maybe you think you want to make the colors of the scratches and dust in another color. And of course you can do that. You can make it look like this pretty easy. You just have to change a little thing. So let's look at what we do. So here we have our dust elements again. And all we need to do to change the color is to change the composite mode to substract. Whoops. And we'll do that again. Subtract, and we'll do that for the last one. So now we have it with the black instead. Black stripes. So again, we can then take again down the opacity of that so it's not so noticeable. Like so. Something like that. Okay. And of course, you can also change the speed of the scratches if you think they are too fast for you. You can change it so it'll be a bit slower, if that's what you're going for. So I don't necessarily want to do that, but it's an option, and of course you can do that. You can manipulate with things like that for the scratches as well. Anyway, I do hope you found this video useful. If you did, please hit that subscribe button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it will help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on the channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.